the holes are traced out. Alright, so we cut out most of the holes, except for the small ones, which we can just paint over. Next is this side, and here are some of the scraps. Alright, so we have the first blade cut out, and we're going to use the first blade as a stencil for the rest of them, so that we can cut out an exactly identical shape to the first one. Okay, so we got the painting phase. So we have the handle painted with gold. We're using some folk fur metallic pure gold, which is not exactly the color I want, but it's good enough. I can't paint the 3D printed PLA that well. I might have to give it multiple coats for it to actually look like this gold. The bottom of the handle is also painted. Instead of making cutouts for the gears, we painted in the tubes. This is going to be painted with gold soon. I'm not sure exactly what this is. Right here, we have the blade, which is painted with silver. We're using metallic stirring silver. and I think this is actually pretty accurate to what I'm going for. And now, right here, we have the holes, and we're actually painting out some of the holes instead of cutting them out to save time, which I think looks okay. You know, like from far away, looks pretty decent. Same on here, and this is what it looks like on the other side, where it's not painted. All right, let's get to it. This is what the traced out version of the pen looks like. And this is what the final version should look like. Some felt wrap around the handle to make, I actually don't know what it's called, the handle wrap. I'm going to start with some hot glue. This side. And then I'm going to wrap this around the handle. Slowly. You know, and maybe I'd put hot glue here, but for now I'm just going to try using tension to keep it down. Or not tension. Actually, yes, tension. And, you know, hope that works.